The defendant then announced, "I'm going to kill this."
A stark opening statement from prosecutors as the first-degree murder case against LaTanya Congress began to take shape Wednesday.
This was a chaotic scene, crying, hysterical people, children.
Congress faces charges she stabbed and killed her niece, Shatavia Cece Alford, in October 2009. Both sides described a hysterical and confusing scene that day.
Ms. Congress got hit inside of the head and she did not remember what happened from that point on.
At the heart of the first day's testimony, Congress's sister-in-law, Helena Copeland, who made the 911 call.
Who threw the knife?
My aunt threw the knife because they were fighting, and she threw the knife.
Jurors heard that call several times, then from Copeland herself, who described a fight between Congress and her niece.
She was mad.
Copeland said she helped break up the fight, thought it was over, and then heard Cece Alford screaming.
And she started jumping up and down, screaming, and then the knife fell right there on the floor by her, and then the blood was splashing on my face, so I started moving back from her.
Congress's lawyers have challenged Copeland's testimony, saying she changed her story. On the stand, Copeland said she was threatened by family members.
They said that better not go to court and say what she said on the stand.
Also in question, the fate of the knife. Police say it's shown in photographs, but it went missing at the scene. That and other details will likely take weeks to hash out before the jury, as will testimony about LaTanya Congress herself, who, despite the fight she detailed, Copeland described with kind words.
She's the sweetest person in the world. Like, she's so sweet. Like, she take care of all of kids.
Among what we're likely to still hear through this trial, testimony from police officers on the scene, family and friends and experts. The state has also said there is a recording of LaTanya Congress's statements to police immediately after this happened. They're likely to play that recording for the jury as well. In the Vermont newsroom, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5.